one of a former local model turned entrepreneur. Now I'm just a working class citizen, and I decided to basically use my growing platform to take a stance on growing issues in our community.
Enjoy the fact that I could always go back to my previous content from last year and the year before that, and I could always maintain my same position that I've always had. So the most frustrating thing for me in realizing what's going on with this R. Kelly case is how easy people can be manipulated and bamboozled. Even when you can see the consistency coming from this channel, it's funny how some people can let individuals shift their perspective of me as a person when me as a person has nothing to do with my content. If you recall, even though I was skeptical of dealing with people involved with this whole R. Kelly sector, as they call it, I gave people the benefit of the doubt. And even when I saw a whole lot of sketchy things going on, I still gave people the benefit of the doubt, thinking that maybe they weren't aware they were being used to set up these narratives to make R. Kelly look bad. Many times I tried to put it in their face. Many conversations I've had trying to be the peacemaker and keep everybody on the same page, which is focusing on R. Kelly. But when you notice these people keep bringing their personal beefs into the mix, again, it's all an underlining issue. And the issue is always usually around money, scamming, side deals, all this stuff that has been going on behind the scenes. And that's across the board, from people within R. Kelly's camp, to the bloggers, to the people who are opposed to R. Kelly. It is what it is. All these different people have their own objectives and their motivations as to what they're doing. But you have to be able to see past the smoke screens. Because as I told you, some of these people within R. Kelly's camp have been playing on his fans. Even those that aren't in his camp that are trying to capitalize off of this situation are still trying to use his fans. With all the things that's going on, it's hard to keep up when you see all these distractions in your face, I know. But if you stay focused on the key players, it'll all make sense in the end. Especially when you see them playing on fans. Let's take the woman you just heard, the very first person I gave an opportunity to, whom I saw hop from platform to platform like I've witnessed many subscribers do. The minute I don't go along with their distractions, they go to another platform and get entertained. And then they come back over here and want to drop the distractions in the comments. And then when I block them, then you notice people making little slick comments about prima donna. What's funny is those same people with those slick comments, those same people that are sitting in these chats disrespecting me, will then try to use their subscribers to come ask me to visit their platform for whatever reason. Make that make sense. You see, I peep game, and this woman who you heard earlier in the audio is the same woman who I've mentioned multiple times, hopping from platform to platform, who pretty much told me she believed Rashona Lanfair was testifying against R. Kelly, who even blocked me because I refused to go along with that story. This is the same person who tried to sue a girl that's in the indictment, JP. All this went down in this fan group, which I told you, I believe there was an R. Kelly imposter who later revealed himself on YouTube. Ever since then, we see all these people trying to cover up for what this individual did. And let's be clear, the individual that I speculated it was, even in the past, as I do now, was Don Russell, period. Now, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But from all the evidence that I have acquired, from all the things he has gotten on public platforms and said, it would be just totally far-fetched for some strange person to be the person behind all of this fraudulent activity when we have a journalist who interviewed with someone who he claims was R. Kelly's manager, who pretty much solidified in his mind how R. Kelly is guilty. And you can go back to the video I did in which it highlighted the shady activities and stuff like that going on R. Kelly's verified Facebook page. Which will bring you to the question I've said so many times. These people keep going to these bloggers with these minimal subs for these narratives. R. Kelly has millions of fans. Somebody had access to R. Kelly's verified profile at one point, so they're not just going to convince me that all of a sudden they don't now when they were promoting the I Admit song on Julius's SoundCloud. All this was linked to R. Kelly's verified Instagram. And then we have fans who have sent me screenshots and all these messages from people posing as R. Kelly. Fans posing as other people saying that they were scammed by imposters and all this, trying to put it off on another individual. All this stuff was going on in the background, and it solidified to me what I was seeing in these indictments. According to the federal government, these people that they say were in the enterprise would gather personal and private information about people, and then they would try to blackmail them or extort them. Isn't that what we're seeing over and over on YouTube? On both sides. Every time these people try to get close to someone, they'll get mad at them and then they try to expose them. But they'll never come out here and tell you real facts or expose when these people that they claim are such good and reliable sources are caught up in their bullshit. As I told you 2 years ago, I believe this was some backdoor dealings in which they had no idea this would spiral out of control as it did. And all these people were just doing some opportunistic type shit. The problem is, whether they felt like they were helping R. Kelly or not, the things they did are going to be held against R. Kelly. And the sooner his fans recognize that and start to place accountability where it needs to go and stop defending individuals, you will see what I see. And that is, I don't believe it was Rashona Lanfair who was going or who did testify as people tried to convince me, as I mentioned earlier in the video. I believe the person was Atlena Prado, the same person who I told you was in the tape 2 years ago. The same person these twins came out here and validated by referring to as Beverly. Again, all these people who like these sources, they get them on their platform, they get them to tell y'all all kind of bullshit, but then they glide right past important details like what I just said. Make it make sense. These people knew back in 2018 about surviving R. Kelly. Yet, for some strange reason, they couldn't go to R. Kelly's cousin who has connections at CBS, Ben Ivory, I believe his name is. They couldn't go to any of these other people who they have these connections with. They come to YouTube. Like I said, my job is to just state what I'm seeing and give you my perception of what's being put out there. That's it. It seems like to me, other people are intimidating, coercing, bribing, all this stuff that would make up a RICO enterprise. So it seems like to me, a whole lot of people have yet to be arrested while they're sitting here pointing all the fingers at R. Kelly.